faced a mountain that I've never faced before. That's why I'm calling on you, Lord. I know it's been a while, but Lord, please hear my prayer. I need you like I never have before. Sometimes it takes a mountain. Sometimes a trouble seems. Sometimes it takes a desert to get a hold of me. Your love is so much stronger than whatever troubles me. Sometimes it takes a mountain to trust you and believe. Forgive me, Jesus, I thought I could control whatever life would throw my way. But this I will admit has brought me to my knees. I need you, Lord, and I'm not ashamed to say. Sometimes it takes a mountain. Sometimes a troubled sea.
Life is a story. A story where choices can end good life.
Life is a story. A story where the weak will be praised and the vulnerable will be struck down.
Life is a story. A story that has no human-made happy ending.
Do you know of that special someone? That woman that you can spend your life with? That woman that you can't live without? The one who's faithful, honest, affectionate, and trustworthy. She who I can make my best friend and a good wife, who will become one with me in mind, body and spirit. Well, that's not my story. This is my story. My wife and I, our marriage. One would advise me to leave, or advise her to leave. But what God has put together, let no man put asunder. We'll work through our differences, 'cause we love each other.
Almost done with the assignment. We only left with half of the body and conclusion and the reference.
I can't keep up.
No, we need to do this thing. I mean, like in 2 hours, I have to be gone. And down.
I'll take a nap. I'll be up in 10 minutes.
Pam, no! We need to finish this thing.
I know, Lindy.
Dear, I know that you're pregnant, but you need to finish umsebenzi wesikolo before you sleep.
Well, good thing you remember that I'm pregnant.
By the way, did you tell Uchali about this pregnancy of yours?
For what?
I mean, he needs to know. He's the father, for God's sake.
Lindy, please. I'm not up for this lecture now. Do you think it's easy popping out of someone's door, boom, I'm pregnant, it's 8 months?
He has to know because funeke ayazi into yoba ngabapha une responsibility engumntana.
Lindy, I'll deal with that bridge when I get there.
Pam, I understand that you two have differences, but you need to buy umxelele uba you are pregnant. Pam?
Lindy,
Are you gonna tell the guy or not?
I will when the time is right, just not now.
Okay. Fine, baby.
Lindy, what are you up to now?
None of your business.
Lindy. Lindy, I'm serious.
Hi, Charlie. It's me, Lindy. Yes, Charlie, I'm good. Pam wants to tell you something. Sounds important, though. Yes, she's here with me.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Mkalele. Hello. Charlie.
Yeah, it's been a long time. Well, I need to talk to you. Tomorrow's fine.
Yes.
On campus, yeah, fine.
Why?
Sure, thanks.
What was difficult? You see? Ha! You're gonna thank me one day. I know.
Shut up.
Don't say it now. I understand.
As young as you are, especially
with your sister, Mpo, Madara. I'm so sorry, my daughter.
I'm not mad. uvelaphi njani?
Makalubhele.
Ah, susondela, susondela kum, susondela. Susondela kum, uvelaphi?
You see the time that
Choma was not yet. I was not yet, child.
Sunbamba. Okay, sorry. Look, the time, you remember the time that I left? Remember when I left? Remember?
Come on, Chalu, bow ya.
Can I explain?
Every weekend when you have a story, Oko.
Excuse me.
Come, Chole.
Wait, can I explain?
Wait,
can I tell you what happened? Okay, so the guys were like, let's go clubbing. I'm like, I can't go clubbing because now I've got a woman.
But who am I, Lemos?
Peer pressure.
Peer pressure, and on every weekend. Okay. Every weekend, peer pressure.
Okay, I'm sorry. This is the last time.
Wait, I'm sorry. So, this is how you show your love with a hand. This is how you show your love.
Sorry.
This is what you always say. Come, Lali.
Lala. But so
ungrateful when I child, very ungrateful.
I love you. Thank you.
He's all built up and all that, and he was hitting on me. And I was like, no man, let me just play hard to get, you know, almost as a lady before you get, you know, you have to bow lalo hard to get.
And the hairstyle was on point.
Oh yeah, yes, Mr. I was the ish last night, and I was the only girl that couple there, actually. Wasn't that Saturday? That's actually. Sakur! Hello! Hi! Why not, Chomi? I mean, like, you guys broke up.
I know, but still, he isn't singing like this.
So?
Hi, guys.
Hey, Sakur.
How are you, Pam?
Pam is fine, and I'm also fine. We're just doing good. And by the way, how's marriage life? Is there anything interesting? Anything, like, come closer, man.
Marriage is always marriage, eh? I'm good. Everything's fine. Pam, you're pregnant.
Well, even a dead person can say that she's pregnant. She's like about to give birth in any time. She's been going on about pregnancy, how she feels. And
thank you. Whatever.
Oh, so Pam, tell me, is Charlie the father of the baby?
Yeah, he is.
Okay. So, are you guys still together?
No, we're not together.
Oh, okay. Sorry to hear about that, hey?
Yeah, no. It's fine.
It happens. Life is. Yeah, you know, these things happen.
that awkward moment. You guys need me. You should just accept it. You need me. So, Tako, is there any hunks at your church, like Abafika, or, you know? I mean, like, Chubby and Donnie. Chubby, come on, I'll wait on that. Tako, I mean, like,
we need to get
to it.
Hey, dude. No. I'm at the department. Yeah, I'm here to see Pam. Yes, that Pam. I don't know. She was like, oh, I want to see you. And all of the other ones. I don't know. But I'll tell you later. Sure. That's hot.
Charlie. The old Charlie, I know.
How? What? What happened? You look
like Tyra Banks?
No, you look like Tyra that swallowed the bank.
Shut up.
Girl, you look big.
I feel big. What do you expect?
Like who knocked you up?
You knocked me up.
Yeah. We tried to be fun. Yeah, sure. Like, seriously, who knocked you up?
Charlie, you knocked me up. It's been 9 months now. And that's what I called you here for.
Pam, it was just a simple question needing just a simple answer. Pamela, umithiswe ngubani?
Oh my gosh, I feel like slapping you right now. Charlie, this is your baby.
No! 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 No, but really, why would I impregnate you? Like,
so you think I wanted you to impregnate me, yeah?
No, I can't have a baby.
Look.
No.
You know, I thought by now you'd be grown, but it's clear that you're the same old Charlie.
Like, why are you lying? Why?
Why would I?
Why are you lying to me? I don't have no baby.
Charlie, listen. I want you to hear me clearly right now. This is your baby. And I came here to tell you. Because I didn't want you to think that I would knock you out. So, I see you're not grown yet. So when you finally grow up, take responsibility of your actions.
Dropped out of school really because of a boy. Mpo, Mara, what can you for role model are you? Mpo, you are my bigger sister. Funa in jungle, kumzo jonga kwenja ni mawiyeki skolo pagati. Nadana. Anyways, 21 minutes remaining. Kalubu ya tuta biyatinga bay, kutale kubuza. Sure.
Zedwa, can I talk to you? I've been thinking we've been spending too much on our finances.
Spending too much? What do you mean?
Yeah, like, we're too much in debt now, and I think it's gonna affect both of us if we don't deal with it now.
Like, please get on point.
Yeah, alright. Okay, I think you need to cut down, maybe not too much, just a little bit on your shopping.
Hey! Oh, hey, my daughter. You're telling me to cut down on my shopping with my own money? My own money, I have to be telling you. When I see the shoes, I have to be telling you. Oh, honey.
Zoda, please listen to me. I'm not saying this plan at all. I'm saying that maybe just cut down a little bit.
It is my own money.
You don't get one thing. What you do affects me. And what I do affects you. We are in a relationship, so
yes.
Can we at least do things like as one?
Things are being done as one here. I show you my shoes when I come back, my handbag when I buy it. I come and so show you. What do you want? What else do you want?
Okay, the other time you bought a couch, you didn't tell me anything about the couch. I came from where? Boom, I found the couch there. There's no communication. And it's affecting both of us. You see now? That's why we're fighting all the time. Why? You do things, you don't consult me.
Why do I have to? You always come home at your own time. So why do I have to? I will do things on my own way. You don't tell me
and
what
that
to do.
Exactly my point. What you just said now, it shows you don't respect me. There is no respect in this relationship. And it's gonna affect us.
I mean, Zoko, what is your point? Respect, communication, financial, money, shopping. What is your point? What are you trying to say?
I'm saying that if we can fix these things, maybe things can be smooth for both of us.
You know what, Ntako? Leave me alone. Leave me alone. I'm sick and tired of your complaints. Okay? Leave me alone.
You must have been in a place so dark you couldn't feel the light. Reaching for you through that stormy cloud. Now here we are again. Troubled soul, God only knows what went wrong. And why you leave the stage in the middle of a song? Trouble, oh God.
now everything had just gone. Because she was just yapping and yapping and yapping. Hello?
Swaying in the early autumn breeze, a golden sun is shining on my face. The tangled thoughts I hear, a mockingbird sing.
It's just good.
It's this old world really ain't that bad a place.
What's happening?
Hello?
Oh, I'm good. Thanks, Andrew. Awesome. Okay, let me check his number. 8376. Okay, there's a knock coming. Come in.
Oh, what's that clue?
Hey, Ntsako, how are you?
I'm good, Pastor. How are you?
I'm good, man.
Yeah.
Good to see
some
you.
Some time, eh?
Yeah, it's been a while, man. It's so scarce. What's
yeah, oh, I've been busy with work and family.
Yeah. Actually, but I was about to leave, man. Is there anything that...
Yeah, I'm not going to take long. I just want to talk. You know, like,
yeah,
I know, like once in a while we need to have our talks, you know, like
yeah.
Nice talk.
Yeah, that's important.
Yeah,
iron sharpens iron.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, I'm just gonna go straight.
Yeah.
The same issue again.
Mm.
Me and Zoda, I mean, it was worse, but now it's like it has gone from worse to worse.
Mm.
We are not getting along.
Yeah.
Yeah. We're always fighting about little things. She doesn't want to talk, you know, like every time. Like I come back home and I know that something happened in the morning and then I want to talk about it. And then she's got moods.
Mm.
She'll be like, oh, I don't want to talk. You always want to talk. I don't know if I can handle this kind of a thing. It's pretty hard for me now. Okay, the last time I talked to her,
yeah.
I was like, let's talk to somebody because me and you can't talk to each other and come to an agreement.
Yes.
And then she was like, oh no, now this marriage is no longer about two individuals. Now you have to bring the third party.
Mm.
You know, she's bringing all this drama. Mm. And you know what my problem is before this?
Yeah.
I guess my problem. I am trying. I'm trying so hard to bring solutions to make us to agree.
Yeah.
She's shooting them down like every time. It's affecting me. Yeah. I can't pray because I'm thinking about it.
Most men don't talk. But you actually had the courage to come and talk about it. Also, what I've highlighted as you're just talking to me is that it's Zodwa alone who has to blame or is to blame this thing, of which I don't really, really encourage that, because I believe that marriage, it's not a one-man show. You're both involved in it. So I'd like you also to visit your faults as well. Maybe there are faults that she sees in you that you don't recognize that you have those faults. But all in all, what I can say is that you pray about it, go to God about it. He's faithful, he's the one who will save and who will rest your marriage.
Okay, here's the thing, Pastor, here's the thing.
Mm.
You see, even when I want us to pray as a couple,
yeah.
That is impossible. I can't pray with her. When I try to bring prayer, she shoots, like I told you, every idea I have.
So I'd like us to pray before we depart. Gracious God, Father, we come to you, Lord God Almighty, as our God. You God who blesses marriages. Father, we pray now at this time that you help Nzako in his marriage. Fix his marriage, Jehovah God, fix him, Lord God Almighty. For it depends on you and the marriage, Lord God Almighty, for it to be strong, you need to help them. Father, great, and we thank you.
Lord God Amen. Almighty, I pray that Lord, fix my wife. Lord, you know I've run out of strength and I did everything I should have done. Lord, I played my role as a man and I just pray, God, that you change her. Like, Lord, you know her and I can't change her. I tried. I'm praying right now that, Lord, you deal with her and she changes because, Lord, I can't take it. I'm praying that, Lord, you will heal our marriage and change her, that God will live happily thereafter. I'm praying that God, even when we talk and then I want to talk to her, that you give her the desire to listen to me, oh God. Change my wife, Lord. Change her heart and perhaps give her a different heart, oh Father. I'm praying that you give her a kind heart, a heart that will respect me, a heart that will make me feel that I'm the head in the house. Lord, you know my heart, you know my efforts. I've done everything I should have done. Lord, I'm praying right now that you heal our marriage. I'm praying that God, whatever difficulty we had, I'm praying that God just deal with her. And if her heart can change, Lord, I've tried changing her heart. Lord God, she's hardening her heart. But Lord God, what I know is that when a God, you can change your heart. The same way, oh God, you changed Pharaoh's heart to be hardened. I believe, Father God, you can soften your heart. I'm praying right now that God, you heal my marriage. In the name of Jesus Christ.
Charlie, I cannot be here. Like, I've been trying, but my family needs me. And my life is just so, so wrong. It's such a mess. I cannot stay here. I need to go home. I just need to go home.
And the eggs?
I just have to go, Charlie. I cannot stay there.
Where does that leave us?
No, I cannot stay here, Charlie.
So you're leaving me?
Charlie, stop asking me questions. It's just not fair. It's not fair for
me. On who? On you or on me?
Just, I have to go, Charlie. I just have to go.
Sorry.
Scary, you don't do that.
Hey,
I've been thinking, you know. Recently we've been having some fights, and I don't like it when we have fights and then things are not well between us and the station and...
Well, I understand.
Yeah, and I want to apologize for the other day. You know, like things almost became physical and...
I know, and I'm also sorry. I didn't mean all those. I don't know.
Yeah.
Yeah, I also want us to fix things.
Yeah, like I miss those days when it was fun and all butterflies in our stomach.
We just got married and...
Yeah, I think we should go back there and stop these pieces of fighting every day, you know?
Yeah, I miss those days too.
I miss those days and I really love you and... I was just telling Mom Chris the other day about... What's wrong now?
You're okay.
What's wrong now? Zodra! Honey!
Hi.
Charlie.
How are you?
Responsibility. I know we've life is a story your choices can end good life. But Jesus is a choice one makes to eternal life.
Life is a story where the weak will be pressed and the vulnerable will be struck down. But through Jesus, though pressed on every side, we are not crushed. Though perplexed, we are not in despair. Though persecuted, we are not forsaken. Though struck down, we are not destroyed.
Life is a story. A story that has no human-made happy ending. But life is a good story. Because life is Jesus without end. Happy ending. But life is a good story. Because life is Jesus without end. I don't need to claim this over and over again. I'm smart.
I see. Take this.
Oh, yes. Thanks for you. Life is a story. A story that has no human-made happy ending. But life is a good story. Because Jesus is life without end.
Yes.
Nailed it!
Yeah.
But through Jesus, though pressed on every side, we are not crushed. Though perplexed, we are not in despair.
How?
Life is a story. A story that has no happy human. Life is a story. A story that has no human-made happy ending. But life is a good story. Because life is Jesus without end. Via Nelly. Life is a story. A story that...
Crow, King Man.
This is
the crocodile
is you,
King
Man. I need
the water. It's a story.
Mm-hmm.
A story. Life is truly a story.
Yeah.
A story.
Life. It's a story. A story that... Life is a story. A story that... Life is a story. A story that...
Life is a story where your choices can end a good life.
It's in a good life.
Life is what?
A story.
Oh. Life is a story where your choices can end a good life. Jesus. But Jesus. Let's try one time. Life is a story where your choices can end a good life. But Jesus is the only choice that one makes. Life is a story where your choices can end a good life. But Jesus is the only choice that one makes. Life is a choice. Life is a story.
We are not in despair. Though persecuted, we are not abandoned.
Shots! What is
the last
of those? Good evening, honey. I'm home.
Hey.
Who's
sweetie, wait. I can't tell you.
You got stuck.
It was my day.
What's wrong, man?
It's not Suji no more.
Really, sweetie, really, sweetie, really.
Sweetie, don't take your time.
Oh, God. I've got a headache, man. And maybe I just need to go back to church and just sort everything out. I really need to go.
I know.
Guys, let's put the eggs in the bag. I was just capturing my moment. Did you look at the camera for a bit?
Yeah. What happened to the last one, though? Tommy, don't go there. I mean, like, Tommy to stay with one man. Tommy? Tommy? I think we're
not going
to. Don't show me. Hello.
Hi.
You guys broke up.
I know,
like,
but still.
You haven't
seen me.
So? How is it?
Hi guys.
Hello.
How are you, Pam? That's.
Wow!
Come on, it's the head.
and a tail.
Am I giving birth to a rabbit?
Ayo, mama!
Fondo,
move your hand.
Fondo, push. Push.
Clap, maybe clap. Maybe blow again. Yeah.
Wow. You've come on.
No.
Okay, I think that was gonna be okay.
What sweet?
Too bad I'm not a woman. I want to defend.
Do it, sweet. Do it.
Life is a story. A story, Dada.
Hello? I'm God. God is good in you.
Thereafter, I'm praying that God, even when we talk and then I want to talk to her, that you give her the desire to listen to me, oh God. And you help her to respect her man, Lord, because sometimes you can cut it. Sometimes I'm in the mood.
Yeah.
What the bloody hell, man?
And Paul will be shocked. Like what?
Yeah, I'm sure.
But we should see
instead
it.
Instead of saying sleep, I'll say I take off your t-shirt.
You wanted to do what?
Because we want to see some black.
Have we come?
I've faced a mountain that I've never faced before. That's why I'm called.